Why is this so close? Do you know what today is? Today is, wait, I'm not, that's so stupid. Oh, I'm back. I'm back, but I'm better this time. This time I am like, wait, what? So yeah, needless to say, I'm back. All the vloggers are quaking. When Casey Neistat watches this, he's gonna be so shook. Logan Paul, Jake Paul, they're gonna be like, fuck. Like, she's back. Like, she is back. And she's gonna take our spot as best vlogger. And I know it. And I'm excited for it. And no, I'm not. Okay, anyway, today's New Year's Eve. We're doing a couple fun things today. By the way, it kind of looks like I might have gotten lash extensions. No, actually. My eyelash is actually just glued. There's like lash glue stuck and it's like making all my lashes clump together. So I just have one huge clump of lashes. It's one master lash to rule them all, really. So yeah, anyway, I've been doing really well since Vlogmas ended. Really well. Anyway, we're gonna go downstairs. I have a new breakfast routine, so you guys are gonna be freaking shook out of your mind, okay? Out of your mind. What? You're not ready? Oh, you're not ready? Okay, I'm going downstairs. Here is my favorite thing that I own in the entire world, my air fryer. So here's what I do. I'm putting this in here. I put it at 390. I also put my little breakfast sausages in there. Let's do 12. Then you literally just leave it and you're like, okay, I have so many things to do now, like I could just go over here. So while that's going, I have a toaster oven now, which has been the light of my life also. So I put my English muffins in here. I put it to like around that number. I don't even know what that is. I put it to toast and then I do, yeah, to like in the middle of those two. He said he's ready for the vlog.
I'm ready for a vlog, going to church.
He's wearing a Christmas sweater. He's doing a turn so we can see.
You like?
And Jax likes it. Jax, you love it, yeah, you love it.
Why don't you go to church, Kylie?
It's a little too late for me to turn my ear around. I'm zoomed in all the way on your face.
I'm wearing Maybelline.
Dude, only cruelty-free on the channel.
Wearing Catrice.
I am gonna start doing my makeup. Oh my God, I can't look at myself right now. I feel like I'm just gonna have to do one of these. This is called, who are you typing to? That there better not be any girls in that game. I'm gonna start getting ready. Let's try this. So the makeup's done. What are our freaking thoughts? It's for the New Year's Eve, even though we're not going anywhere today because I don't like New Year's Eve. I think it's stupid. I don't like to go out and I don't like to feel pressured to go out. So you know what? I'm just not doing it. I'm not doing it. Actually, I asked you guys on Snapchat because what do I do when I don't know the answer to something and I can't figure it out on myself and I can't make a decision? I asked social media. So you guys picked out, this was the one you picked out. This is from Beauty Creations and it's called Metallic Bling. New Year, same me, because guess what? You should be wearing, this is what I don't like about New Year's. People wear glitter and they're like, okay, this is the one day of the year where it's acceptable. No, you should be wearing glitter every day of the year, like me, okay? This is nothing new. This is a regular Tuesday afternoon for me. A regular Tuesday, 9 a.m. for me. I, no joke, when I used to have like actual college classes, I would wear glitter to my 9 a.m. class. Life's too short. Where are the freaking glitter? Anyway, I'm gonna go eat some freaking lunch. That just took me a really long time to get ready. And we're going to see a movie too. We're seeing Pitch Perfect. Oh, is it 2 or 3? I think it's 3. So Jarvis and I are seeing that. The rest of my family is going to see Daddy's Home 2 again. And I was like, no, I'm not going to see a movie twice. I'm just not that kind of person. My brother and my dad are serial movie watchers. Like, they go and see a movie 10 times in the theater and they pay every time. I'm like, why do you do that? Just watch the movie once and then wait till it comes out. Like, it's gonna, just wait a few weeks. But they have to go, like, when Hunger Games came out, they went and saw it 7 times in the theaters. 7 times. Yeah, like, hey, are you freaking kidding me? Anyway, okay, I'm gonna go eat now. This is not normal that he lets people do this. Boo, are you living your life? Are you living your best life, honey? I am alone and I'm going to Pottery Barn, which is kind of weird. But I really wanna get this one robe. I've been thinking about it for like, I don't know, my whole life, kind of. Just kidding. I've been thinking about it for a long time, like probably a month. And by the way, I am so sorry. You guys are gonna hate me. I forgot to tape down the side things again. So if you're like wondering why you hear that stupid rattling, it's because I am the worst vlogger on the entire planet Earth. Ugh, I can hear it. I'm so sorry. I feel so bad. So yeah, anyway, I forgot to tape them down. I freaking suck. Sorry if there's a little bit of a razzle dazzle rattle. Here's the deal. The reason why I'm going now to get the robe, first of all, I'm scared that the stores are gonna close by the time that we get out of the movie, because that's when Jarvis wanted to go, and I'm like, no. I am not waiting till after. I will not be deceived by holiday store hours. So I really want to have the robe for tonight, because guess what? I don't like New Year's, okay? I think it's the dumbest, freaking stupidest holiday ever. People like me, I don't care. I don't like to go out. It's just another day of the week. I feel like it's stupid that people feel like they have to spend $400 at like a restaurant or like downtown or something in order to have like a successful New Year's, and like people build it up so much. And I feel like if you just have no expectations like me, like I never do anything on New Year's, and it's always like what exactly what I want to do. I never do anything on New Year's. I went out one time in college, like my freshman year, and I was just like, okay, don't need to do that again, you know? It's not like, I don't know, I just like, no thanks, like rather not. So anyway, if you didn't do anything, then just always know, you guys can always pretty much count on me. I'm probably not out. And you know what? I'm going into 2018. Here's my New Year's resolution. Here's my actual New Year's resolution. I want to put a lot more effort into YouTube and really give it the good old college try. I didn't take it really seriously till the end of the year, and I feel like I need to dream a little bit bigger with it, and I think then it'll become, you know, what I want it to be. And I think it could be something really awesome, and we could finally actually become a YouTube celebrity and not just like say that I am. I'm just kidding. But you know what I kind of mean, right? Or not really. Like, oh my God, you guys, I have a fashion haul coming up. It's going to be like a new year, because I'm reinventing my style, as we all know. I started doing it at the end of the year during Vlogmas, and I'm in the process right now, as you can see. But anyway, for real though, what am I trying to say? Hello, can somebody please help me? Can someone please help me? Yeah, I'm doing a fashion haul. What the hell? Can I talk, please? Anyway, I'm doing a huge fashion haul. I'm so excited about it. It's like gonna be the craziest, like freaking littiest lit. Well, I'm not gonna say the word lit. It's gonna be good. It's gonna be cool. It's gonna be cool beans. So, yeah. Also for 2018, try to put cool beans in every sentence. just kidding. But yeah, those are my. Comment your New Year's resolution. Comment it, and then you can come back to this video a year later and be like, did I complete it? I set low expectations for my resolutions also. So at the end of the year, I'm not disappointed. And I feel like, oh, well, yeah, I accomplished it. So what about you? Okay. Turn my car on, probably. What's that? Oh, okay. I was like, what is that noise? So that was a bust, unfortunately. And let me tell you why. Anyone is curious. The robe, so I saw it online and I was like, God, like that's really expensive. It was a $98 robe. And I was like, okay, you know, I really want that robe, and I do get a lot of use out of the current robe that I have, which Jarvis, by the way, that pink one that you guys asked me about a lot is from Kohl's. And it was like not that expensive. And Jarvis got me it. But that one was $98 online, and I was like, wow, you know, and it was sold out online. So I was like, okay, you know, I didn't even see that it was on sale. I don't even remember it being on sale. I guess it was the day I looked at it, because it's actually $129. I got in there, it was $130. Why am I beating around the bush? It's $130. Anyway, I was like, do you guys have any sales? And she's like, well, if you spend over $100, you get like 15% off or whatever. And I was like, okay, so it's still gonna be way over $100. It's gonna be $115 or something like that, or $100, maybe more like $120. So like, I'm not like, I'm sorry, but no, like I'm not. I don't want to spend that, you know. I was already like kind of not okay with spending $100 on a robe, and then I was just super, super not okay with the idea that I would have to spend $130. So I'm gonna go to Walmart and try to recoup. I'm just kidding. God, Pottery Barn's really expensive, dude. Like, they are, I mean, it's the best store. Like, when I hit the lotto one day or something. Actually, I'm not gonna hit the lotto. I just know I'm not. I've never won a lottery ticket before. Like, not even like a scratch off. Like, I don't think I've ever won a scratch off. So I just know it's not gonna be the way for me. I'm gonna have to make money through hard work and manipulation. But anyway, when I'm like rich and famous though, I'm definitely shopping at Pottery Barn. But like, and the people were really nice in there. They really were, and I was surprised because a lot of the time, like at those like kind of higher end places, they're used to dealing with only like the rich and the famous. Yeah, no, I'm just kidding. Nobody rich and famous lives around here, but they were really nice. And I just have to say that because I feel like whenever I do have good customer service, like they deserve it, you know? Because I usually have bad. It's like everybody hates me. Oh, come on. Why did I do this, dude? All right. Sorry, losers. I'm going. I'm sick of it. What are you doing at Trader Joe's? Come on. I actually love Trader Joe's. Can't even lie. I'm back. Let's do a little bit of a haul. I gotta take these off. I cannot see. So, first bag. I got these. These are incredible. If you haven't tried them, they're water. It's like sparkling water, except it's not like gross sparkling water. It tastes exactly like a grape Fanta or grape Crush, but it's water. And you'll like, it makes you pee a lot. It's really, I think it's like, if you're a pop drinker or soda pop drinker, then I would get those. They're only at Walmart. That's the only place I've ever found them. You gotta go, like you have to go. My favorite one is the white grape. And then I also got, I'll show you in a second what else I got, but then I got this. I had to get this. I got this is an XL from the men's section, a NASA t-shirt. By the way, there was Call of Duty, like pajama pants. NASA, gotta love it. Gotta, you freaking gotta love it, dude. And then I got this. They already have, oh my God, this looks so cute right here. Ooh, that looks so cute right here. Anyway, they already have like some, what's it called? What is this called? Valentine's Day. They already had some Valentine's Day stuff, so I was like, yeah, I want that. I got the cans. I haven't tried the cans yet, but I got the orange ones, so I could put them in my mini fridge and hopefully be a little healthier, like, you know, stop drinking so much regular Coke, you know? This is the bag that you guys probably want to, wait, what is what in here? I got this, it's called Goo Gone, and it gets off like that adhesive, like sticky stuff, so that's for Jarvis. Here you go. This is like the grand finale, the main show. Okay. So the hats were mostly $2, or they were on sale for $5. So this is a $2 one. It's just kind of like, it looks like a worn-ish kind of like, all right, that doesn't look too good right now, but like on my regular hair it does. And if I get this a little bit tighter, it's just like a regular freaking hat, whatever it is, right? Then they have a pink. Anyway, I think this will look better like when I'm not wearing my wig. It's just like my regular hair. But they're pretty cute. This is like a velvet pink one, and it was like $2. I found this hat. Are you freaking kidding me? Velvet red with a really nice black bill, and it's pretty big. Like, it feels good. Look at this. Isn't that cute? I think this is so freaking cute, so freaking stylish. I've been looking for like a red one, and I just feel like this is the best color. Like, this is the best one I've even found, and it was at Walmart on sale for $5. It's canceled for Target. Target's canceled officially after I found this hat. Like, come on. Come on, like, come on. Like, what else? Let's see what it looks like with my famous glasses that are so not famous to me, but whatever. Okay. I don't know about that. The cabbie hats, the Baker Boy hats, love it. Oh, and then I know you guys hate this. Like, everybody comments that they hate this whenever I wear it, because I have like a maroon one. But I got a black one because I wore it the other day with like a messy bun on the top of my head, and it looked cute, but I was like, God, I wish I had a black one instead, like, and not like a, you know, I just wanted one that like matched stuff better. So these are $2 at Walmart, so it's like, you know, even if people hate it, it's like, who cares, you know? Oh my God, this is such a cute freaking hat, dude. I feel like I'm hungry again. I feel like I just ate, but I'm hungry again. I feel like I'm gonna eat some soup, because soup is guilt-free. Kind of. But anyway, that's my haul, Walmart haul. I know you guys, get in your car and go to Walmart right now, okay? Get in your car and go to Walmart right now. Okay, on our way to see Pitch Perfect. Everybody else is saying Daddy's Home. I think I already said this, that I'm not gonna repeat myself, but we're on our way. I switched my jacket out. This is a jacket from, it's called Honeybum is the company. So I'm gonna do a haul on it. I'll link it below though. And I got it in a size large, which is actually just the right size for me. But anyway, that's where we're going. See you there.
There's not three.
No, it says you only get three flavors.
Well, because nobody's ever gonna choose lemon.
Oh, well. You only lemon?
Isn't that
the options are clear. Strawberry, grape, and apple.
Gosh. Strawberry, lemon, apple.
You guys, I have the funniest story. So we're back for the movie. By the way, let me give you our review. We saw Pitch Perfect 3, and it was good. It's like every other Pitch Perfect movie, so if you like Pitch Perfect, you'd like that one. And there was like some funny parts in it, singing good songs, you know, the usual. The funniest thing happened. Oh my God. 2017, they had to get one more embarrassing thing in there for me. They had to just sneak one more incredibly, like, I was like, holy crap. So we bought our tickets online, right? So I got a confirmation code. So we went to go get our, like, I went to go type in my confirmation code at the little, there's like a little self kiosk because I do not like to deal with people, you know? So I went to do it. I put my thing in. It said, sorry, we cannot process it right now. Go see the kiosk or like the person at the desk or whatever. So I was like, okay, whatever. So I ended up texting myself. I text myself pictures from my desktop computer, and like I send them back and forth between my phone and my desktop because it's just easy that way. And then I like drag it. I don't know how to use a computer. Okay, I just don't know how to use one. So that's the best way that I found, is just texting myself pictures and like moving them around. So I had texted myself a picture that I had edited on my desktop to myself because I needed it for my phone to post to Instagram. So I texted myself like our reservation code, so it didn't work. So I had to go up to the kiosk girl, but then I'm like, okay, yeah, like I have my confirmation right here. And she's like, okay, what is it? And I'm just like, I hand her my phone, just not even thinking, and like, because she started reaching for my phone, so I gave it to her. But it was on this, it was on my picture, right? And I'm like, oh my God, first of all, that's, I'm like, oh yeah, like, you know, that's a picture of me, sorry, kind of weird, you know, like. But then I'm like, oh, I forgot about which picture it was. It looks like I'm holding a freaking dildo. And I'm like, I mean, it's the curling iron that I use. And it, like, but I had to tell her, I'm like, oh my God, by the way, that's, she was like looking at me weird. I'm like, oh my God, by the way, that's a freaking curling iron. Like, not what you think it is. I swear I'm not like a total weirdo. Anyway, she was like, oh yeah, I see that it has a cord in it, so we're good. And I'm like, okay. I mean, it was embarrassing because I had to like explain to her, like, no, that's not what you think it is. I know it looks like anal beads or something like that. Okay, you guys, happy new year. Hopefully you're seeing this on New Year's Day, which is actually today because it's 1:47. We already ate breakfast, so I'm just saying, you guys, like, catch up to us. Like, just catch up, okay? We're already way ahead, and I'm about to have lunch in about 2 hours. No, I'm just kidding. That's the end of the day. I'm not gonna make this vlog any longer than it is because I'm editing it right now. I'm like, I am talking way too much, dude. I'm talking way too much. Anyway, talk to you guys later. Bye.